बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स डिस्कस कंक्लूडिंग पैराग्राफ। अ कंक्लूडिंग पैराग्राफ इज़ योर चांस टू रिमाइंड द रीडर ऑफ योर थीसिस आइडिया एंड ब्रिंग द पेपर टू अ नेचुरल एंड ग्रेसफुल एंड। अकॉर्डिंग टू जॉन लिंगन, देयर आर थ्री कॉमन मेथड्स ऑफ कंक्लूजन। You may use any one of them or combination of them to round off your paper. The first one is end with a summary or final thought. Second one is include a thought-provoking question or short series of questions. And the last one is end with a prediction or recommendation. So let us discuss each one by one. The first one is end with a summary and final thought. When army instructors train new recruits, each of their lessons follows a three-step formula. Tell them what you are going to tell them, tell them and tell them what you have told them. An essay that ends with a summary is not very different. After you have stated your thesis, it means tell them what you are going to tell them. Definitely, whenever you write a thesis statement, you tell them what is you are going to tell them, what is in your mind. And supported it means tell them, that means supporting detail. You restate the thesis and supporting points. Tell them what you have told them. However, don't use the exact wording you used before. For example, there is a summary conclusion. Online shopping at home then has several advantages. Such shopping is convenient, saves you money and saves you time. It is not surprising that growing numbers of people are doing the majority of their shopping on the internet, for everything from turnip seeds to television. Note that the summary is accompanied by a final comment that rounds off the paper and brings the discussion to a close. This combination of a summary and a final thought is the most common method of concluding an essay. Second way to conclude your essay is include a thought-provoking question or short series of questions. A question grabs reader's attention. It is a direct appeal to your reader to think further about what you have written. A question should follow logically from the point you have already made in the paper. A question must deal with one of these areas. There can be WHY question, what question, or which question. What the subject of your paper is important. Why the subject of your paper is important. What might happen in the future. What should be done about this subject. Which choice should be made? In your conclusion, you may provide an answer to your question. Be sure, though, that the question is closely related to your thesis. Here is an example. See here, first he has asked the question, then he has given the answer. Similarly, you can do the same thing, that in your concluding paragraph, you ask a question or two questions and then you answer them in that one. For example, what then will happen when most of the population will be over 60 years old? Now, here he is going to give you answer. Retirement policies could change dramatically. When the age 65 testimonial dinner and gold watch postponed for 5 to 10 years. Even television would change as the Red Bull generation replaces the Pepsi generation. Glamorous gray-haired models would sell everything from toilet paper to television. New soap operas and situation comedies would reveal the secrets of the sunset years. It will be a different world indeed when the young find themselves outnumbered. Last one is end with a prediction or recommendation. Like questions, predictions and recommendations also involve your readers. A prediction states what may happen in the future. If people stop to think before acquiring pets, there would be fewer instances of cruelty to animals. Many times, it is the most who adopt pets without considering the expense and responsibility involved who mistreat and neglect their animals. Pets are living creatures. They do not deserve to be treated as carelessly as one would treat a stuffed toy. A recommendation suggests what should be done about a situation or problem. Stereotypes such as the ditzy, blonde, harried, executive and annoying in-law are insulting enough to begin with. In magazine ads or television commercials, they become even more insulting. Now, these unfortunate characters are not just being laughed at. They are being turned into hucksters to sell products to an unsuspecting public. Consumers should boycott companies who advertise and continue to use such stereotypes. So these are three ways to conclude paragraph. So three examples are given here. I have also got these examples from John Langan's book. First, include a thought-provoking question or short series of questions. You can go through it. And second one is end with a summary and a final thought. You can read it. And the last one is end with a prediction or recommendation. So these are three ways to conclude your essay.